हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम रमन गुप्ता फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज बारा एंड इन दिस वीडियो वील स्टडी द पोएम नेम्ड द सॉलिटरी रीपर कंपोज्ड बाय विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ. विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ अबाउट होम वी हैव रेड इन द लास्ट वीडियो. विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ is considered a poet of nature and romanticism. So this poem is the best poem which tells us about the poet's company with nature, or when the poet went in the company of nature. So let's start this poem. First of all, I'll read the text and then we'll explain it. Okay. Behold her single in the field, yon solitary highland lass, reaping and singing by herself, stop here or gently pass. Very beautiful lines and often asked in exams for explanation. Alone she cuts and binds the grain and sings a melancholy strain. Oh, listen, for the veil profound is overflowing with the sound. Behold means to see. Lass is for girl or a damsel or a beautiful lady. Reaping is to cut the crop, and melancholy is full of sadness. Veil is for valley, and the next stanza, no nightingale did ever chaunt more welcome notes to weary bands of travellers in some shady haunt among Arabian sands. A voice so thrilling never was heard in springtime from the cuckoo bird, breaking the silence of the seas among the farthest Hebrides. In this stanza, the poet tells us about the beauty of the song sung by this highland lady, this lady whom he saw on the hill, who was reaping and collecting the grain from the fields, and while doing that, she was singing the song. The poet sees a highland girl in the field. This girl is reaping the crop and singing to herself. There was no one there who could listen or who could hear it except the poet. But the girl was not aware of the poet. So, without giving any notice, he heard her song, and she sang the song. The poet likes this scene. He says to the passers-by, either to stop there quietly or to pass from there without making the least noise. The poet did not want to disturb her because the melody of her song was very much effective, and poet did not want to lose that if she would stop singing that song. So he requests the passerbys, the people who were coming here and there from that way, to not to make a noise, to लेट द गर्ल सिंग द सेम सॉन्ग. द गर्ल इज कटिंग एंड बाइंडिंग द क्रॉप अलोन एंड ऑल्सो सिंगिंग अ सॉन्ग. दिस सॉन्ग इज ऑफ सैड नेचर बट द पोएट लाइक्स इट वेरी मच. एक्चुअली द सॉन्ग इज अ मेलनकली सॉन्ग, अ सैड सॉन्ग, बट द पोएट्स लाइक पोएट लाइक्स इट एंड दिस इज द रियलिटी. Always the most beautiful songs, the most melodious songs, the most memorable events, incidents are those that tell of saddest thought, that tell us about the sad thoughts. We forget happy moments of life, but sad moments can't be forgotten ever. They can be less remembered, but completely to forget them is not possible. So the same thing is here. The song is of sad nature, but the poet likes it very much and wants everybody to listen to it. The song is also echoing in the valley. The valley is profound with the harmony of that song, the melody of that song. The poet thinks that in the second stanza, let's repeat it again. No nightingale did ever chant more welcome notes to weary bands of travelers in some shady haunt among Arabian sands. A voice so thrilling never was heard in springtime from the cuckoo bird, breaking the silence of the seas among the farthest Hebrides. The poet thinks that even the nightingale, famous for its singing to the tired travelers in the Arabian desert, where they take rest at an oasis, cannot sing better than this girl. Students, nightingale, the bird nightingale, is famous for its song. It sings very well, very melodiously. And the poet says that, as everybody knows, that in the ancient time, in Arabian deserts, where the travelers used to go, and in between their way, they used to take rest at oasis, where there was the song of nightingale. The song of nightingale could be heard over there. But the poet says that even the songs of nightingale are very good, very melodious, but they cannot compete. They cannot be better than the songs of this girl. The singing of the girl is also better and more thrilling than the cuckoo bird, which sings in the spring season and then breaks the silence of the seas among the far away Hebrides. From the large oceans, there is no sound in the winter season, in the spring season. But when the cuckoo bird sings, it seems that it breaks the silence of the area. In the same way, the song of this girl is melodious and no other sound can be heard. So it is
undisturbed song of that girl, and the poet want to listen to it for a longer time. Next stanza, will no one tell me what she sings? Perhaps the plaintive numbers flow for old, unhappy, far-off things and battles long ago? Or is it some more humble lay, familiar matter of today? Some natural sorrow, loss or pain that has been and may be again. In this stanza, the poet asks questions to himself that what is the content of the song of that girl? Around which topic, around which subject she is singing the song? He does not understand. He could not understand the subject matter. But he makes an estimate that could be a plaintive number. The poet is unable to understand the language in which the girl is singing. He does not know the same of the theme of the song and wants somebody to tell him the time, the theme. He thinks that the song is about old, unhappy incidents or of some battles in the past. The song can also be about some familiar matter related to the life of the girl. The song may also be about some natural sorrow, pain or loss which has happened to her. The last stanza, whatever the theme the maiden sang, as if her song could have no ending, I saw her singing at her work and over the sickle bending. I listened motionless and still, and as I mounted up the hill, the music in my heart I bore, long after it was heard no more. The poet does not think too much about the theme of the song. He is enjoying the song heartily. The poet thinks that there is no end to the girl singing, as if she will never stop singing. It seems to him that the song of the girl would never come to an end, because he was feeling very amused to listen to the song. He watches her singing and using the sickle to do her work at the same time in the field. The poet says that he listened to her song without making any kind of movement and noise. When the poet went up the hill, he says that he still remembered the music of the song which that Highland girl sang. The poet also says that he will always remember her singing. The remembrance of this, of listening to this song of girl, would always be in the mind and heart of the poet. So this is all about the poem and its explanation. Let's have a look in the summary also. The poet saw a Highland girl. This young girl was in a field. She was all alone. She was reaping the crop and binding it into sheaves. She was also singing a sad song. The sound of her song was echoing in the whole valley. It could be heard even beyond the valley. It was flowing in the whole valley, so it could be heard anywhere in that valley. The poet did not want to disturb her because he wanted to listen to the song of the girl without any disturbance for a longer time. The poet did not want to disturb her. He stood silently to listen to her song. He did not make any noise lest she should stop singing. The song of the girl was really very sweet and charming. It was sweeter than the song of a nightingale. Tired travelers resting under a tree in an oasis. After their long journey in the deserts of Arabia, find the nightingale song very sweet and charming. These songs provide them comfort, but no nightingale could have sung so sweetly as the solitary reaper sang. So, here the poet says that no other song can compete the beauty or the melodiousness of the girl's song. The cuckoo bird heralds the onset of the spring. Cuckoo birds sing welcome notes in the Hebrides Islands in the northeast. They welcome the sailors. Their songs break and silence of the seas in spring season. Their songs are very sweet. To the poet, the song of the solitary reaper seemed sweeter than the song of the cuckoo birds. The solitary reaper was a Highland Scottish girl. She was singing in a hilly dialect. The poet could not understand what she was singing. There was no one around to assist him, so he started making guesses. Perhaps she was singing of some old sorrowful things of the past or battles fought long ago. She might be singing about some unusual, unpleasant things or known problems of day-to-day life. It might also be about some natural sorrow, loss or pain that might occur or recur. The poet could not understand what she was singing, but whatever was the theme of her song, it affected him deeply. Like her work, her song seemed endless. He saw her singing and reaping in the field. He listened to it while standing quietly for a long time. Then he climbed up the tree. He carried the music in its heart, though he could no longer hear it. Students, the rest of the part of this poem, analysis and critical appreciation, we'll discuss in the next video, because if I'll discuss it here in the same video, it will be very difficult to upload it. So thank you, read it well, and you can get your doubts clear if you have any. Thank you and have a nice day.